Yasir Qadhi seems to be lying. He simply lied. That's what I believe. Shabir Ally is a punk. Shabir Ally is a punk. Okay?
That's what Shabir is saying. There's direct takfir.
What is this, Ya Shabir? The Quran now isn't what it has always been? Has the Quran been tampered with? Is the Quran no longer preserved? ما في مشكلة تكفير يا أخي. Live. We don't care. I agree with David.
What's up, everybody? God bless you all. David Wood recently released a video where he spoke about Sneako's terrible reason for converting to Islam.
Looks like Sneako is about to have a really bad week-o.
Farid did a response stream to David's video. In that stream, he actually ended up agreeing with David Wood.
I agree with David.
Here are some clips from his stream where he not only agrees with David Wood, but has some words for Yasir Qadhi and Shabir Ally.
When one of our own lies, we let it go? Is that what we're doing?
As Dawagandists do, they lie and contradict themselves. We'll see how Farid does that in this very video where he calls out Yasir Qadhi for doing the same thing.
There has never been two copies of the Quran that are different even in one letter or one word.
If you were to compare two printed Qurans, you're going to see differences between them.
But world-renowned Quran scholar Sneako says you're wrong, Sheikh.
It seems like Yasir Qadhi's lying. That's just the reality. From my perspective, Yasir Qadhi seems to be lying. He said every single mushaf has the same dots. Is that true? It's not true. In the second video, he's clear about the reality and he affirms the reality. So those are two different things. I believe that he finds the topic of the qira'at to be problematic for like the layman audience. And therefore, he simply lied. That's what I believe.
One of the most confusing issues of ulum al-Quran is haqiqat al-ahruf.
When one of our own lies, we let it go? Is that what we're doing? No. This is a major issue. Yeah? Anyone who lies gets called out. It doesn't matter if they're a Muslim, doesn't matter if they're a kafir. It's the first video, the one with the white background, where he's saying something that's simply untrue. Okay?
Here's Dr. Shabir Ally.
Today, most Muslims read the Quran in a text that is referred to as the Egyptian edition of 1924.
يعني شوف Shabir Ally is a punk. Okay? Shabir Ally is a punk. When you say something dumb like this, we read the Cairo edition of the Quran. Shal kalam. Who says this? Who says we read the 1924 Cairo edition? Well, you're making it sound like the Quran was written 100 years ago. How the hell does that work?
This cuts away at the sense of complacency that many Muslims have gone around with, thinking that, okay, you know, everything has been preserved dot for dot, letter for letter, the way it was revealed to the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, with no variation or change whatsoever.
So I don't know what Shabir is saying. If he's actually saying the Quran is not preserved, then Shabir's a kafir. Simple as that. Yeah.
These were always known in scholarly circles to have existed, but recently, average Muslims have just simply without bothering to learn, they have just simply parroted a common way of speaking about the Quran and saying, you know, it's 100% the way it's always been. And
what's this? What's this? This is an issue. What is this, Ya Shabir? Now Shabir needs to explain this. This he needs to explain. يعني the Quran now isn't what it has always been? يعني has the Quran been tampered with? Is the Quran no longer preserved? If that's how you feel, say it. ما في مشكلة تكفير يا أخي. Live. We don't care. That's what Shabir is saying. There's direct takfir. No issues.
But where did they get the idea that they keep parroting?
There has never been two copies of the Quran that are different even in one letter or one word.
From their scholars.
But yes, you see, I agree with David.
Notice, Muslim scholars have always known about different versions of the Quran. For a book that supposedly has no...
shuffle, guys. Here's the thing, yeah? Here's the thing. David needs to stop being... He just needs to stop being... David, Shabir Ally is saying that scholars have always affirmed these attributions, or they've always accepted these attributions, and they've always had these recitations, and yet they're all saying the Quran is preserved. They're not saying Ibn Mas'ud's messing up. They're not saying Ubay is messing up. They're not saying Naf' is messing up. They're not saying Abu Amr ibn A'la is messing up. They're not saying that. They're affirming these things.
All right. Here's actually where Farid is messing up. He's claiming that his scholars don't say that these canonical readings messed up or that they were wrong. However, Farid is doing the very thing that he just accused Yasir Qadhi of doing. Lying. Farid knows that some of his classical scholars, such as At-Tabari, actually did in fact say that the readings Muslims accept today as canonical contain mistakes.
There's definitely At-Tabari without a doubt. He's very open about this, and ulama are very open about this. At-Tabari does reject some canonical recitations. This is something that's well documented. Everyone knows this.
When one of our own lies, we let it go. They're not saying Ibn Mas'ud's messing up. They're not saying Ubay is messing up. They're not saying Naf' is messing up. They're not saying Abu Amr ibn A'la is messing up. They're not saying that.
At-Tabari does reject some canonical recitations. This is something that's well documented. Everyone knows this.
Anyone who lies gets called out.
So there we have it. Farid actually agrees with David Wood. And he excommunicated, or is willing to excommunicate, Shabir Ally, say that Yasir Qadhi is a liar. At the end of the day, all Muslim scholars are liars. Every single Muslim needs Jesus. Turn away from the liar Muhammad. Come to Jesus, the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus is Lord, and Islam is false.